Is your site currently showing an internal server error on it? Well, don't worry. I'll show you four different methods that you can use to get it up and running quickly. The internal server error is actually an issue on the server itself. And sometimes it's not anything to do with your website or your WordPress installation, but sometimes it is. So we'll go through these four items, but just know that you may have to contact your hosting provider as well. Now note, some of these solutions will also be involved using an FTP client. There are several to choose from, but the one that I'll be using in this video is FileZilla. So make sure you get your FTP credentials ready and an FTP client installed on your computer. All right, if your site is down, the first thing that you can look for is you can check for a corrupt htaccess file. To do that, let's open up our FTP client. On the right, you want to make sure that you're inside the public HTML of your website so that you can see things like your htaccess file. Let's right click and rename this. You can rename it anything. We simply don't want it to be the htaccess file name. Once you rename that, you should be able to go to your website and see if you can access it. If you can access it, then that's great. Then we'll just need to do one quick thing to get you back up and running quickly. And you'll want to make sure you go into the dashboard of your website, head down to settings, permalinks. You don't have to do anything different to it. Simply scroll down and click save changes. That just makes sure that your permalink structure is the same and that all of your URLs can be accessed correctly. And you should be good to go. Now, if that didn't fix anything, then head back over to your FTP client. The next thing that we can look at is it's possible that maybe you can access your website fine, but you can't access the admin site. If that's the case for you, then increasing the PHP memory limit could help you. Open up a notepad or something that you can type in and add memory equals and then the amount that you want the limit to be. I'm going to do 128 to just be on the safe side, and we'll need to save this. Save it as php.ini. Once we save it, we need to upload it to our admin folder. So on the right, I'm going to click on admin. On the left, let's click refresh. And here's my php.ini. So I'll right click on that and upload it. Now that that's uploaded, you should be able to go back to your dashboard and see if you can access your admin area. We've had several users who've tried that and it worked for them. Now, if the admin area isn't the only issue, or if none of these have fixed your problem so far, then we'll need to do something else. What we'll need to do is we need to deactivate all of the plugins. It's possible that one of your plugins is causing the issue. So on the right, let's make sure that we go up to the plugins area. Once we can see WP admin and WP content, let's double click on WP content. And you see the plugins folder here. Now we want to deactivate all plugins at the same time. And the fastest way to do that is to simply rename the plugins folder. So I'm going to right click, rename. You can rename this to anything and just say deactivate. And then you should be able to go to your website and see if it works. If it does work, that means that one of your plugins is corrupted. You'll need to activate each plugin individually until you can find the plugin that is corrupted. So you'll want to go back to the FTP area and we'll rename this back to plugins. So I'm going to right click, rename. I'll remove that to just plugins. The cool thing about WordPress is once I deactivated everything, all the plugins are in deactivated mode. So we can just head back over to our WordPress dashboard, go down to plugins, installed plugins, and all of the plugins are here. They're just deactivated. So activate each one individually. And when you come across the plugin that causes the problem with your site again, then you know that that's the one that's wrong. Now it's possible that one of the core WordPress files is corrupted. So we can try uploading a fresh set of core WordPress files. To do that, let's head over to wordpress.org and we'll download the most recent WordPress installation. Once that's downloaded, we need to extract the files. All right, now that we have the folder here, we only want to upload two folders. We only want to upload the admin folder and the WP includes folder. That ensures that your theme and all of your customizations to your website stay the same. So let's go back to our FTP client. On the right, I'll click refresh to see the latest. I'm going to go into my WordPress folder and I want to click on the admin, and then I can control click on includes. That's on the left. On the right, we want to make sure that we are in the right folder. So I'm going to click on the dots to go up one more level. And you see the admin and the includes folder here, so we know we're in the right location. On the left, I'm going to right click and click upload. We do want to overwrite, and let's go ahead and say always use this action and apply it to this queue only. That way we won't get this notification anymore. So let's click OK. And this will take a little bit of time to upload. You see there are several in the queue and how many are being successful. So I'm going to pause this and we'll come back when it's done. Now those files have been uploaded, you can hover over to your site and see if it works for you. One of those four items should have fixed it if it's a WordPress related issue. If your site is still suffering the internal server error issue, then it's likely something to do with the server that your site is on, and you'll need to contact your hosting provider to get them to fix it. Did you learn something from today's video? If so, subscribe to our YouTube channel and we'll send more helpful tips to help you manage your WordPress website. And thanks for watching.